Welcome to WaterQ. In a minute, we'll be talking to Dr. Patab of Silab International Organization and winner of the Stockholm 2009 Water Award.
Thank you very much.
India had three problems, basically, in the field of sanitation. One, rural areas, there are no toilet in any house. My mother, my grandmother, sisters, they used to wake up early in the morning to go to defecation over there. So ladies had to suffer the most. They had to go before sunrise or after sunset. Sometimes they had to face criminal assault also. And snake bites were also reported. Girls did not go to school because there are no toilet. I studied in four schools and no school had a toilet.
Four schools.
See? And then the children used to die because of diarrhea and dehydration. My own sister's son died because of diarrhea. So this was a problem in the rural areas. Urban areas, most of the houses had bucket toilets cleaned by the human scavengers. Only 15% of the population of the urban, they had some facilities of septic tank or sewer system. 85% had nothing. Only the bucket toilets or they going outside for defecation also in the fringe of area, the town or the slum areas. So and these human scavengers were treated very shabbily. Had not they cleaned the toilets, people would have died because of epidemic, cholera and others. But just see what society did for them. They did immense job for them, but they placed the scavengers, the untouchables, scavengers on the lowest ladder of social structure of Indian society. And call them untouchables.
You call them?
Untouchables.
Untouchables.
Yes.
Finally, yeah. I just want you to give us an idea of how India may look like in the next couple of years with regards to improving sanitation.
Actually, now India has technologies. So it will get more coverage. Those countries which have not developed their technologies or have not adopted solar technologies, that will be difficult for them.